Okay, what we have here are two examples of potential energy questions that involve actual numerical calculations. They're not much different than the basic ones. The first question here, here's your potential energy diagram they gave you. Is this endo or exothermic is the first question. And all you have to do is look at the shape. If you start out lower, the reactants have a lower energy than the products, then that's endothermic. You can spot it just because you end up higher. Let's see, determine the heat of reaction for this reaction. All right, heat of reaction. That's the difference between the products, which are right here, and the reactants. Now, because we have numbers, the products are 100, the reactants are 50 kilojoules, so when you subtract, you get 50, but make sure you include the positive sign. We mentioned before in the first question that endo, you can tell it's endothermic, that positive sign also indicates it's endothermic, and that's your value for your delta H. Determine the activation energy for the reaction. Activation energy is abbreviated EA. So what we do is, here's your activated complex up here at 250. And the energy that we start at as a reactant is 50. So whatever that difference is 200. So you have to put 200 kilojoules of energy in to go from your reactants all the way up to the top of the hill to progress to the products. What's the energy for the activated complex? Well, the maximum energy achieved in a reaction is called the activated complex, and that's 250, and this is kilojoules, all of these. Determine the reverse activation energy. So let's say we went backwards. So if we were to go backwards, you'd have to get up the hill from this point, and that means we're going to have to go to 250, and we're starting at 100. So we'd have to add 150 kilojoules to the system to make it reverse and go backwards. Alright, next one. This reaction, what we see here. So the first question is endo or exothermic. See how we start higher and we end lower? That's exothermic. Let's see. The delta H. So we have to do products minus reactants. There's our products, there's our reactants. Our products are at 20, our reactants are at 40. Let's just kind of follow those over. And you get negative 20 kilojoules. Now, this is important that you put the negative there, because negative and exo have to go together. The activation energy for the reaction, well, you start the reactants, the energy to get up that hill, so the hill has, the top is 100, and we start at 40, so that's positive 60 kilojoules. The activated complex, that's the maximum energy achieved, so I go right to the top, that's 100 kilojoules. And the last question, determine the reverse activation energy. So starting from the products, we have to go all the way up to the top. So it's going to be 100 minus 20, which is 80 kilojoules to reverse this. If you ever had a catalyst, you'd probably be cutting that hill in half. It goes like that. This is your, I guess, level 2 or your second video on potential energy diagrams. Hope that helped.